might be the only participant in the project who never signed the guitar.
It's gonna happen.
It's gonna happen if you remember to remind me tonight. I was on my way to a gig. I dropped the guitar off at Jeffrey's house. I got a text message from him. Did you sign the guitar? No. No, I didn't. It's like, okay, because I was thinking maybe you signed it somewhere really strange and I couldn't find it. No, no, it's just not there. So I had sort of been, stewing on this situation. Friend of my wife's we were watching a couple whose lives have been turned upside down by various circumstances, and been on my mind a lot, and so that's sort of what came out in terms of topic of the song. First thing I noticed about the guitar is that it's sort of a big body guitar, similar to mine there. It's got this interesting hole right here. It's very unusual. And it sort of changes the listening experience for the player. So you've got this, right? So you're catching that. The first thing I heard was the low end of this guitar. And so I dropped the low E string to make it even lower. Sort of lean into that a little bit. And I was playing. So once you put it in drop D, you sort of just, you play a D chord. And I did that. And suddenly I was in my grandmother's house.
Goddamn hard.
There ain't knuckles left to skin. And these hands that turn the wrench are like the ones that turn the clock. Both move fast as hell, and neither one knows how to stop. Now